afternoon, Nerd Fam, and welcome back to fabulous Washington, D.C. We're here at NVIDIA GTC with special exclusive coverage on theCUBE. My name is Savannah Peterson with two very special guests today, Mike and Will. Thank you both so much for taking the time out of a busy week.
You're very welcome.
Thank you, Savannah.
So there's some really fancy hardware with a name that's really important in technology right now sitting here in between us. Before we get rolling, Will, tell me what's going on here.
Okay, this is our new N9100 switch, which we developed in partnership with NVIDIA. It is orderable in another week or two, and it is this has been a very key thing. So when we had Jensen come by, he did want to take the opportunity and sign it, and we had Cisco people pressing him in to the point that...
It's so cool, it's right here.
Yes.
Yes. Was that a moment? Did you feel a little bit like a celebrity?
I was standing right there, and I have photos of it that are on LinkedIn, so very, very happy with that.
No, it's really exciting. Congratulations on the announcement as well. Mike, tell us a bit about WWT.
Sure. WWT, we're a worldwide integrator, that whole worldwide term, but we are one of Cisco's largest partner, so we work with them often, NVIDIA as well. So when we look at what we're doing across AI, and we're here talking a lot about AI stuff, it's really across like high-performance architectures, it's some of the AI solutions, and physical AI, robotics, and digital twins. So we work very closely with Cisco and work with our customers to frankly develop some of the coolest things on the planet right now.
I can just sense your, what's the coolest thing that you're working on right now that you can tell me about? I just saw your excitement there.
I can, so a robotics thing, I can't tell you who it's with, but it has to do with robots picking broccoli, like biped robots.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, very cool.
So. I love this stuff. Physical AI, the manifestation, and getting to see AI in the wild, it's such an exciting time. What about you, Will? What's the coolest thing you can tell us about that you're working on now that we're here?
Oh, so probably it would be not as fun as the physical AI, but it's more some of the new chip developments with optics moving forward, putting those together in large systems, liquid cooling. Yeah, I mean, there's just a lot changing on the infrastructure side. But yeah, not as cool as picking broccoli.
It's all pretty cool.
It's very cool. What, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
That stuff doesn't
run
without the infrastructure piece. So.
Totally.
Yeah, you gotta have that.
No, you absolutely do, and I really feel like nerds are having a moment right now. Like, we're all of a sudden the coolest people. Like, this is like a Taylor Swift signature, except it's Jensen, which is so awesome.
One of the most important people on the planet is a geek like us.
Yeah, I know. What validation for all of us as a community. Well, talk to me a little bit about the partnerships here and how important partners are like Mike in this ecosystem.
Yeah, so... WWT, first of all, has been a partner. I've probably worked with them over a decade, but for a very long time. And I think one of the key things about WWT is it's deep technical, so things like the AI validation lab, where there is very significant both equipment but also software stacks that come together. And so when we work with WWT, it's an engagement that is not only around customizing for the end customer, but it's around access to engineering and a full solution level partnership.
And I feel like partnerships and collaboration and trust, frankly, have never been more important than they are right now, especially with the velocity that we're innovating. Mike, tell me a little bit about some of the challenges you see. You get to work with a lot of different types of companies.
Absolutely.
What are some of the consistent themes or growth moments that you've been able to help facilitate?
Sure. Now, I'll start kind of back to the partnership. So, number one, thank you. You guys are an amazing partner for us. I mean, the partnership is just critical. And what you talked about, the AI proving ground and the things we're doing there, just amazing. This AI world is about partnerships. It is an ecosystem-driven world. If anybody thinks that they can do this on their own, they are mistaken. We need partners. When you look at just
so
what Cisco is doing, you look at a partnership with NVIDIA, you need the high-performance storage piece of this, you need the software side of this, and there's nobody out there who is one-stop shop. We try to be, but we partner with Cisco. We don't have some of the expertise that Cisco has. They're the ones that make the products, right? And NVIDIA, they're making the products, so we enable our teams to go do it. But it is an ecosystem world that we live in, and you have to have those partnerships.
It really is key, and there isn't one solution that's going to emerge from this. It's going to be an ecosystem, and y'all are playing in the same ecosystem, which is why you're having the great success that you're doing. What are some of the consistent issues that people are facing when they're getting started? It feels like a lot of people are at the starting gate, kind of doing an MVP, but not really sure. Mike, I'll start with you, but Will, I'd love if you chimed in.
Sure. Biggest thing we see is customers trying to identify use case. right? Understanding
right.
where they're going to actually deploy or what they're going to actually use this deployment for. So you have a lot of different partners. Some of the NCPs and the cloud providers are building the infrastructure in this kind of, hey, build it and they will come. But on the enterprise side, they're looking more at, we need to define the use case first before we build that factory. So I will tell you, that's been one of the most critical pieces. So we look at it as we help drive the use case, demo it, pilot it, production. So that's the way we've been thinking about these challenges.
Yeah, are you seeing something similar, Will?
Yeah, and I think it does vary based on the sort of category. So NeoClouds, we've seen they need to move very quick for the amount they're investing. If they don't get that deployed very quickly, that's money being burnt by
right.
the truckload. And so they are typically very much looking for a reference architecture structure that is something that we can partner with NVIDIA, WWT can help enable and extend on, for instance, with security, as that makes sense. On the enterprise side, they are more cautious and they are looking for more of that going back and forth on the architecture and what would be the goals. And so they're a little more cautious and they do look for more engagement at this point on the details.
I believe that, which I suspect you're able to do. So how does the N9100 here sitting in front of us, how does that help accelerate innovation within the companies you get to serve?
Yeah, so the N9100, one of the key parts about it, so it is running our Nexus and our SONiC operating systems. And one of the key points is underneath it is a Spectrum ASIC, so it's not one of our Cisco Silicon One, but it is one of the NVIDIA Spectrum. And because of that, as part of our engagement with NVIDIA, this system, along with our UCS, is part of their NVIDIA Cloud Partner Program.
Yeah.
And that is something, and especially for NeoCloud, some enterprises are interested, but it's really very NeoCloud focused of that GPU as a service model, and that with this they can get going, but have Cisco providing the overall solution and then supporting them end to end. And so that's a key new component for us.
Yeah, that's really exciting. Will, what does this open up for your customers?
So if you look at this, it gives them flexibility too, right? So you mm-hmm. talked about, SONiC and Nexus OS,
yep.
they have the ability to choose what operating system they want to use on this. And I will tell you, just from an orchestration, mm-hmm. automation standpoint, and tying into what Cisco's doing in the security side, it changes everything, especially in that NeoCloud space
yep.
where we're seeing a lot of traction.
Totally.
And this changes the way people look at networking. And we talked about that. It needs to be, it's literally the backbone, pun intended, right? It needs to be a critical part of the decision making when you're putting this together, you're putting these solutions together. And so our customers are looking at this and looking at us and saying, okay, now we're working with Cisco, we can mm-hmm. deploy this full stack solution in the NCPs, everything, again, from storage, security, the networking, the compute side of things, the GPU side, this is a game changer for us.
And one of the key points is because it's running Nexus, on top of that, we have things like Nexus Dashboard in parallel with Intersight, in parallel with a new software option called HyperFabric. But all of those are extremely API driven, and you can have that common Nexus OS, and then you can have that on a backend switch deployment like this that's east to west between GPUs. But then you can also be using Nexus on the front end, and all of that can be streamlined from a day two standpoint, both a provisioning up front, but then how you manage and monitor it.
And basically connecting to storage, connecting to your front end systems and everything. It's
pretty awesome.
Yeah,
it's extremely
awesome.
Impressive, honestly.
I
bet you made this a little faster than you made things in the past.
There was extreme pressure. I think actually when Jensen was visiting, he was giving me trouble because we talked about this back in February and he said, why did it take so long? And it's like, well, switch development normally takes over a year. So we moved very quickly for this, yes.
It's the fastest I've ever seen Cisco move, and I've been working with Cisco for 20 plus years, and the speed at which they look and got the AI, the compute side up to speed, and what you're doing here, it's a whole different Cisco right now.
Ooh, I'd love to hear that. That's quite a soundbite too.
Yeah, thank you.
yeah, that was fantastic. How are you feeling the pressure, Mike, from your customers to innovate at an accelerated velocity as well? Or are people nervous? Like, what's the culture around solution driving right now?
It has to be solution driven. And like I said, the NCPs are building basically for a they will come, and the enterprises are on the. So when you look at that, there's so much investment being made in the NCPs just from you know, capital markets, and just they're a big part of what we're seeing and doing right now. So when we look at the full stack piece, and they're deploying the full stack with Cisco now where we are with 9100, guess what? We've got them. We can take some of that nervousness away and let them know that, hey, the orchestration, the management, again, the security pieces of this makes a huge difference.
Yeah, it really does make a big difference.
And by the way, in the NeoClouds, I've seen some that are almost seem too fast, where they've gone from funding to purchasing, you know, UCS Compute Nexus within a couple weeks, and they're looking to get deployed, you know, some number of a month or two after that. So some of these, it doesn't seem like they're even pausing to think too much, but we're happy to support them and whatever pace they need to go.
Well, so, and the fact that they can go at that velocity and be enabled by y'all is a really big deal. I think that's awesome. So I love, since we're in a new era of Cisco. Mm-hmm. Well, how do you keep folks like Mike up to date with all the new stuff that's going on? How frequently are you communicating with your partners?
So, I mean, Cisco has had a very, significant partner program for many years. I think, just to use WWT as a prime example, there is not only all of the training and all of the typical engagements, but I'll use from a product standpoint, just last week, I was meeting with folks at WWT where we were talking about, for some new offering opportunities, how we might do some customization so they could do early design for their customers and then move quicker in that standpoint. And so, we view that it is more than here's our product and sell us, but give us feedback on the product. What can we do that helps you? And then a lot of times there's per customer back and forth. And so we obviously then work to scale that across a much larger number. But of course, WWT is special.
We are special.
There you go.
Do you feel special right now?
I do. I'm actually he's getting a hug as soon as we're done. Not doing it on camera, but when we're done, he's getting a hug.
I'll make sure we validate that they actually hugged folks. Okay. Don't worry. Mike, what do you see as the future of infrastructure partnerships? Is it going to be this closer, tighter knit, fast-moving
philosophy? It has to be.
Yeah.
It is such a critical part of what we do. And like Will was just mentioning, what we do with Cisco, we're really integrated into their business units. We're helping to guide and provide input on what they're developing. So it's a really close relationship. It's a joint relationship. They take the time to enable us. They help fund things that we're doing in the AIPG and the AI Proving Ground. So the infrastructure piece is the critical part of all this. And GPUs are extremely important, but without this and without doing it securely, you cannot, you're just not going to be successful.
It just doesn't matter.
Yep.
Yeah. Sticking with you, Mike, what's your advice for companies who, because we are in a state of uncertainty right now, there's this almost like facade of confidence in certain instances, but people are a little nervous about what's going on and how to make smart decisions right now. What would your advice be, besides call WWT?
So, yeah, exactly. So, first of all, call WWT.
Yeah.
But my advice is to understand the cost impact to your business, especially from an enterprise standpoint, and then look from an NCP, look to partner with companies like us.
Yeah.
So we have a sell to sell with model with a lot of these NCPs working along with the Cisco team. So for me, it's understanding what it's going to take. Do you want to build this yourself? Do you want to buy it? Is it going into a NeoCloud? Is it a hybrid type approach? That's my advice, is to focus on those kind of key characteristics. Is this core IP data for me? Probably want to build it on site. If it's this kind of stuff you don't have the power and cooling to do, hey, maybe you want to go into the hyperscalers or the NCPs or work with the co-location partners. So that would be my advice. Start looking there and don't forget about the power and cooling piece, I will tell you.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Great advice there.
Yes. don't forget about that.
Low key, not a thing you should forget about. Well, what about you? What's your advice?
I'm going to probably emphasize reference architectures, and Mike mentioned the NCP. So it depends on the customer segment. NeoCloud, the NCP is a key one, but for broader enterprise telcos, we've been putting together the Cisco Cloud Reference Architecture. We've gone through a validation with NVIDIA on that, and as key part of that, that scales from hundreds, thousands, tens of thousands, and it can help a customer understand what's the outcome they're going to get and what's the component and the pieces that go into it. So this is a further step beyond the old validate designs. It really is a next step, including performance data and so on. So reference architectures are where a lot of this should start.
I think that's absolutely great advice. I have two final questions for you both. taking off your professional hats for a moment, what do you hope that AI does for your friends, family, and loved ones? I'll start with you, Mike.
Okay. So when I first came over to WWT, I was talking with our leader of our enterprise sales organization, and said, why do you want to come work at WWT? This standard question. I told him, we're working with the most influential companies on the planet. NVIDIA partner, Cisco partner, and we look at this and I said, we have the absolute chance to change the course of history. I want to be part of that to do it ethically and do it right. So that's what I look at it. So I hope that, as much as I'm a big sci-fi movie guy and everything, I'm hoping it doesn't turn into Terminator and that we're doing the right things to do it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm with you there 100%. Yeah,
exactly.
Well, what about you?
Well hit, so I have three kids, two of them are in college, and my hope for them is that it gives them an opportunity for lifelong learning in a way that is easier, is able to think about and become sort of medium expert in a much wider, many of us have always had the, I don't know much about that. It's so much easier now, and that's only gonna get more streamlined over time. So rather than abdicating decision making, how can everyone become mildly aware of and a mild expert in many things? And that's my hope for my family.
Was that
his answer was so much better than mine.
I love that. As a generalist, I love that you just said that. Would you like to say hi to your kids right now?
Sure. Hi, kids. Jack, Bridget, Keegan.
Your dad's doing good at work today.
Thank you.
Violet, I'm doing good at work today, too.
Yeah. There we go.
Yes, you are. Yes, you absolutely are. All right, final question for you both. Normally, I say this question with a year out, but I'm going to say with GTC in March, mm-hmm. What do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today? Mike, we'll start with you.
I'll take that one.
Go for it.
So we have in development some key new work around security plus networking in an AI context, and I'm looking forward to some new announcements, which was too premature to put out today, but I'm very excited for GTC US to be able to do that.
Oh, we can't wait to cover that. That sounds exciting. Well, you'll have to keep me in the loop.
I'm actually going to go right down the same line with security. So we've built a security reference architecture with Cisco. We call it Armor. Mm-hmm. And that, to me, is to be able to announce that our customers are using that Armor framework along with Cisco. And we can kind of announce that to the world a little bit more formally and with a little bit more flair.
Oh, I can't wait to see that flair, Mike. It's going to be absolutely great. You keep us in mind when you're announcing all that good stuff.
I will. We'll be there.
Fantastic. Mike and Will, thank you both so much for taking the time. This has been absolutely fabulous. And thank you for sharing your celebrity hardware with all of our guests. Very exciting. And congratulations. Big milestone for you all this week.
Yep. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, absolutely. And thank all of you for tuning in to our coverage here from GTC in Washington, D.C. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.